Welcome back to Summer Extravaganza. There is nothing more beautiful than the Ozarks in the summertime. And when the sun is setting, a beautiful glass of wine, man, I wish Joy was here.
If you really want to have some fun this summer, you need to head north of the city. I am at Uvda Winery. This is Brian. And Brian, your place here is so much fun. It's a little bit like a hidden gem. Talk first and foremost about what brings us here, your wines. How many wines do you process right here on the premises?
Counting multiple sweetnesses, I have 30 different bottles open for sampling.
30 different bottles.
Yep.
Okay, so, and these, by the way, these grapes are by and large Missouri grown, correct?
Yes, and it's not just grapes. We do true fruit wines, actually using the fruit. Some wineries claim to do fruit wines and use cheap apple or grape wine and sweeten back with a flavored concentrate. It's not the same thing at all. It costs much more to make a true fruit wine because all of mine have at least a pound of fruit per bottle, and I can't buy a pound of any of those fruits for what 2.5 pounds of wine grapes cost, and I have to add significant sugar to get the alcohol level up.
Right, so the fruit wines here taste just like eating the fruit off the vine. You'll love it. It's delicious. All right, so talk about some of the different varieties that you offer here.
I make a tomato wine. I make an apple, dry and semi-sweet. The tomato's dry only. Traminette is a cross with the famous German Gewürztraminer grape, so it'll grow in this climate. And I describe it as having a hit of grapefruit on the finish, and that's available dry or semi-sweet. Vignole is a French hybrid grape described as having aromas of fresh-cut tropical fruit and a little citrus on the finish, also dry or semi-sweet. Cayuga White is a grape developed by Cornell and named after an Indian nation. And we've got it two different dry versions of that. And usually my Happy Birthday is made from that as well, which is a Moscato sweetness white wine. And then we have Chamberson and Norton for our reds, and I have three different wines I make from each of those. And most are available dry and semi-sweet unless they've been oaked, and I never combine sweetness and oak. And currently I have blackberry, red raspberry, peach Melba, which is unique to me in the world, and blueberry and strawberry. And then dessert wines, we have a Chamberson port that's a ruby, not tawny, and this is not aged on oak, and it's 19% by fortification. And we have a black raspberry that is quite sweet, more like a liqueur. This is straight black raspberry, 16% by fermentation.
Did you hear what he just said? I mean, did you hear what he just said about all the varieties that you have? So what you're saying here is that you have something for every palate. This may be the place to visit if you're not quite sure what you like in terms of wine, because people can come, have a little sample, and you're guaranteed to find something they do like.
99% of the time, and probably 95% of the people, like so many of them, they have to pick and choose what they're going to take home with them, because I'm proud of that. I've got a reputation for making really good wine.
And you should be very proud of it. Can I ask you where you got your name, Uvda?
I'm Brian Overbow, so it's Overbow's Own Viking Vintner's Distinctive Alcohols. I'm half Norwegian, quarter Swede, and quarter British. I've got a Norwegian family tree back to 1179.
Wow.
So I think that makes me pretty Viking.
You're pretty Viking.
And then
I
we
love
use
it.
We use the acronym and pronounce it Uvda, which is really spelled that way.
One of my favorite things to do here at Uvda is sit out on the lawn and enjoy some live music. Brian, why don't we sample a little bit of this
sure.
wine? And I want you to tell me about what all you offer in the summer, because it's so much fun.
Well, we have free lawn concerts the last Saturday of every month. We vary the time with the season, so it's a more comfortable part of the day. And you can check our Facebook page to see who's playing and what time. You can bring a picnic or a snack if you like. You can't bring your own alcohol, that's against state law, but you can buy whatever you like here and consume it on premises. And it's really the best concert venue anywhere, because you're not right next to the other person. You got room to spread out and you can converse with your friends while the concert's going on. Good idea to bring lawn chairs and blankets if you got them. I've got seating for, maybe 100, but boy, it's, We get quite a few turnout, so.
It's a fun time for sure. And you can get here just by heading straight north on Glenstone. How far north of 44 are you?
3 miles. Come to a flashing red light. It's the only one. You turn left there and go 4 driveways down on the left-hand side.
You can't miss it. It's so much fun for the summer. Trust me on this one. You will love Uvda Winery. By the way, I love the wine. Cheers, Brian.
Cheers.
Go jump in the lake, and I'll show you where. Summer Extravaganza continues.